In this video, I'm going to teach you how to create a backdoor, which is backdoor access to a WordPress website. Now, the whole concept of creating a backdoor kind of has a kind of a hacker connotations with it, and I'm not condoning using this for hacking or anything like that. There are a lot of legitimate reasons why you might want a backdoor way into your WordPress website. So a great example would be if you are someone that creates websites for your customers and you maybe deliver that website before getting paid in full. You don't want your customer to then go in and delete your access, and now there's nothing you can do. You have no recourse in order to get paid. Those are situations where having a backdoor way in is a perfect legitimate reason so that you can still have some recourse to make sure that your client pays you. Another way that you would want to use this perhaps is maybe as an insurance policy to make things easier if something happens with your login. So there are real legitimate reasons why you would want to create a backdoor way into your WordPress website, and in this video I'm going to show you how to do it. Now, where this originated is I recently delivered a website to someone, and I was a little iffy on if they were going to do their side of the agreement, which is pay. And so, just in case, I wanted to create a backdoor way in if they did this to me. So that's why that was the motivation between me learning it. So I'm going to show you this bit of code that I found on the internet. I've got it pulled up right here, and I'll give you a link to pull this up. And essentially, this is just a little snippet of code we need to copy into our WordPress theme. And what it's going to allow us to do is on your site that you install this on, you'll be able to go to a specific URL on the site, and it will create a user account, and then you would be able to log in with that user account and regain access to the WordPress website. And so this is a function, and it needs to go in the function file of your WordPress theme or child theme or both in order for it to work. Now, you don't want to do anything wrong, because if you do, you could make your WordPress website get that white screen of death if there's one character off. So you just want to proceed with a little bit of caution, or make sure that you know how to then go ahead and fix it. And I've got a video on how to fix it if something goes wrong. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this and I'm going to put it in my WordPress site, and then I'm going to show you what you can modify and change. So here's the whole entire bit of code, but we don't need this first line. We just need where it says starts here and says add action. So go ahead and highlight that and copy that into your clipboard. And right now I'm logged into a WordPress website that we're going to test this on. And I'm going to go ahead and go to appearance, and then right here where it says editor, here's a list of the different files that make up your theme. And the one we want to put this in is right here where it says theme functions. And right here it says functions.php. Now, when you're looking here, it might not say theme functions. It just might say functions. But over here, it will say the same thing on everyone's site where it's functions.php. So I'm going to click on that, and it shows me it here. Now, if you want to be sneaky, you could paste it someplace in the middle of this file, but you got to be careful where you place it. You don't want to place it in the wrong spot. So let me show you how I would go about that. So here's where I can scroll up or down in the file. So let's just go maybe halfway down it. And you see right here, let's find a good spot. Okay, we could put it right. Actually, right here is perfect. So you see right here, you have these sections where you'll see a slash and then two asterisks. These are notes. So you would typically want to place it at the top of a note or at the bottom of a note. And so this looks actually really good right here to put it right underneath this. So I'm gonna hit the enter key and I'm gonna go right there and then I'm going to paste that bit of code in. So here is the code that I'm adding. So here's some of the things that you can change in this little bit of code to make it your own. So right here where it says my backdoor, and right here it says my backdoor, you could change this word backdoor on either of them. See, if it says backdoor, it's kind of like obvious that there's some kind of way in. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and change backdoor to say path. Actually, pathway. So I need to have it be identical right here. There it is, pathway and then pathway. Okay, and then this piece right here where it says backdoor, you can change as well. Now this is gonna be used in that custom URL that I said you're gonna visit to trigger this user account being created. So I could make this pathway as well. It doesn't have to be the same as these two. It could be different, but I'm not feeling super creative, so I'll put the word pathway as well. Okay, and now we're at this line, and this is where we're going to specify what the username will be when this is triggered. So instead of Mr. Admin, I don't like that, but we could leave it. Let's call it pathway as well. Fine, why not? Not feeling creative today. And right here, we need this to be the same as what we put here. This is basically saying, make sure, first check to see if there's a username with the account, username with that is pathway. And if there is, then don't create one. But if there isn't, let's go ahead and proceed. So I'm gonna say pathway again. And then here's where we would put in what the password is gonna be on this user account pathway that we're creating. So let's just call it pass and put an exclamation point and then put pathway. All right. And then we don't need to change anything on these two lines right there. So now let me show you what's going to happen. We're going to go to the URL of the website, whatever, and it's a .com. Or actually .dev, we're gonna go to the URL of the website, we're gonna put the question mark, then we're gonna put the word pathway, then we're gonna put the equal sign, and then we're gonna put the word go. So let me show you what that's gonna look like. So it's gonna be, so there's my URL, actually I got that wrong, it's example.dev, and then I'm gonna put a question mark, then I'm gonna put that word I chose, pathway, and then I'm gonna put the equal sign, and then I'm gonna put the word go. So when I enter this in, actually, let me properly format that. So when I go to this visit this URL, it's gonna trigger this little snippet of code, and it's gonna go ahead and create that user account. So let me put this into my clipboard. So now that I've got my function that I created, this backdoor, I'm gonna click on update file. Now here's the dangerous part. If you did something wrong and you hit this, you might get a complete white screen, unfortunately, on your WordPress website, and then you need to know how to go in via FTP or the file manager and fix it. So, but I'm pretty sure I'll get it right. So let me click on update file. And it says right here, file edited successfully, which means it was done correctly. So I'm gonna go right here to users, and you can see the only user I have is this site admin. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go and visit the URL. Okay, I've got the URL in, I'm gonna hit enter, and it takes me to the home page of the site. So there's no visual indication that anything happened. But I do know that this worked. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go back into that table of users, and I'm gonna show you that the user was indeed created. So I'm gonna go right here to my dashboard, click on users, and you can see right there that user account pathway was created. And that's pretty much all there is to in creating a backdoor access to protect you as a web developer to get paid, or maybe to have that a little easy insurance policy to get back into a website. And this is actually pretty secure to use. There's no way for someone to see your functions file without existing access to your website, your WordPress website anyway. So now if you messed anything up and you got a white screen, I've got a video that will show you how to go in and fix that. Now, if you want to implement this on your website, I'll have a link below that will take you over to where you can get this code. And if you're on my website, I'll have a link as well where you can copy and paste the code just like how you saw me do. Now, there is one little caveat that you need to be made aware of. If you place this in the parent theme and then there's a theme update, this function will get overwritten and it will be wiped out. I always suggest using a child theme, and I have a video on how to create a child theme. And in that scenario, you would place this code in your child themes functions file. And then if the parent theme had an update, it wouldn't overwrite this custom function. And if you were doing this for a client that you want to make sure you got paid, I would put this function, maybe to have two variations of it, I would put the function in your child theme. And then I would also, as an insurance policy, go ahead and put it in your parent theme, just so you have two ways back into your website. Well, that's it for today's video. I'd love to hear your thoughts on it in the comment section down below. Please also give me a thumbs up on YouTube. That really helps me out. And if you haven't subscribed yet to the channel, go ahead and click on that subscribe button. That also helps me out. Now, I don't want you to ever leave empty-handed, and that's why I've put together a free video course just for my subscribers called The 3 Steps to WordPress Success. Now, if you would like free access to that course, just go ahead and click right here on the right. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.